Hello everyone, thanks for tuning back in. So today I want to share with you what I do in between my protective styles. This is going to be my updated wash day routine. Okay, so first things first, my hair is getting longer, so now I have to wash my hair in the shower. I used to wash it in the sink, but now bending over, I just can't get my hair nice and clean like I like. Now I notice that when I bend my head over, my hair is more tangled than ever. So now I have to wash my hair in the shower. And it's very, very important for you to wash your hair in between your protective styles, especially if you let them go as long as I do, which is 5 to 6 weeks. But in between that, I am moisturizing my hair and keeping it maintained. And I do have a video that I just put out about that, so you can definitely go check that out. Now, first things first, normally I would do a hot oil treatment, but I didn't have to do it this time because I had just moisturized my hair. My hair was already soft, so I just needed to actually wash my hair at this point. So what do? First, get in the shower and I rinse out all the loose dirt, all the dirt that is on my scalp, all the dirt that's on my hair strands. And then I go back and I start detangling and getting all the shed hair out of my hair. And the product that I like to use to do that is Tresemme Perfectly Undone. It's with sea kelp extract and it is silicone free. It is a weightless moisturizing conditioner. I really like this conditioner. I've been using it now for about 6 to 7 months and it does my hair really good. So this is what I use to detangle. It gives a lot of slip, it moisturizes really good, and it doesn't take me long at all to get my hair detangled and get the shed hairs out of my hair. So Tresemme Naturals is what I use to detangle and get the shed hair out of my hair. Now, next thing I do, shampoo. I know. I'm a big advocate for not shampooing your hair and just co-washing. But when you have not washed your hair in like 6 weeks, it's time to get in there and get some nitty gritty washing going on. You can use one of two things. Definitely a sulfate free shampoo, and the one that I chose to use was the Shea Moisture's Black Jamaican Castor Oil Strength Grow and Restore Shampoo. It's with shea butter and apple cider vinegar, which brings me to my second way of cleansing your hair, and that's just strictly apple cider vinegar. I normally use apple cider vinegar, but I just wanted to give this product a try. I heard a lot of good reviews about it. Now, I do like it. It gives a little slip in there because of, I guess, the Black Jamaican castor oil that's in it. I do like it, but if I must be honest, it did leave my hair still a little dry and stringy. And I probably am not going to use this often, so I'm probably really going to just go back to using apple cider vinegar to actually cleanse my scalp and cleanse my hair strands. Alright, now the way that I use this is on my scalp. I rub it in really good, massage my scalp, getting those cells activated, and then I allow the water to just pretty much run down my hair and letting the shampoo just run down over my hair strands. And then once I get all the shampoo out, I go ahead and do a deep condition. And the deep conditioner that I chose to use is the Shea Moisture's Black Jamaican Castor Oil Strength Grow and Restore Treatment Mask. This is with shea butter and peppermint and keratin. You know, keratin is a type of protein, and peppermint stimulates the scalp, and shea butter is a great moisturizer. So this mask is A1. I will recommend this to anybody. Really like it. I am probably trying to mimic my own conditioners behind this because it really has a lot of good natural products in it. And what I do with this, pretty much just put this all over my hair from root to ends, making sure that I put a lot on there because this is a deep condition. And I let this sit for about 30 minutes. Normally I will take a shower while I'm doing this. No, my showers does not last for 30 minutes, but I still get out of the shower and I do what I have to do. And unfortunately, I do get back in the shower to rinse it out, but it's okay. It's okay. I'm only doing this once every 5 weeks for now. And after that, my co-washing routine is not that in-depth. So I'm not in the shower for like 30 minutes. But anyway, after I do that, the most important thing I do that's going to give that shine back and that moisture locking in is I pretty much do a oil rinse. So I put together a few oil combinations, and the ones that I use is almond oil, jojoba oil, coconut oil, and black Jamaican castor oil. I put it all in this little bottle here with a tip, and what I do is go in and pour it on my hair strands while I'm in the shower, pour it all over, and then I go and rinse out the excess oil that is left behind. My hair is left so soft and so rejuvenated. It's like a staple that I have adopted. Oil rinses, very important. Very, very important. Then after that, I just go ahead and do a leave-in conditioner, and I do that right in the shower also. I like to apply a lot of my product in the shower because it leaves the mess in the shower and not out on the sink or on my floor or my rug or my walls. Yeah, it does get everywhere. So anyway, what I choose to use is the Shea Moisture's Black Jamaican Castor Oil Strength Grow and Restore Leave-In Conditioner. And this one also has shea butter, peppermint oil, and keratin in it. And this particular line is really good for natural, chemically processed, color-treated, or heat-styled hair. I really like Shea Moisture's Black Jamaican Castor Oil line. It's really good. So that is pretty much it. That is all I do in between my protective styles. Again, rinse out the dirt, go in with a co-wash, then I go in with that shampoo or a apple cider vinegar, and then I deep condition for about 30 minutes. And then I go ahead and do an oil rinse, which I love, love, love. And then I go ahead and do that leave-in conditioner. Okay, so that's pretty much it. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below, and I would love to communicate with you. If you have any suggestions that you would like to leave for me, leave them below. I would love to try out the suggestions. I'm going to be in a protective style for about a year, and I'm going to be doing different ones. This one here is one parted down the middle. And I posted a picture on my Instagram page of what it looked like with just before it turned into this. Alright, so go check that out, and I hope you have a great week, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!
And it opens up right here, and it's gray, black, like a grayish, bluish color on the inside with black, and then gray on the outside, and it has three compartments.